x1 into
Yeah. Tell
y1.
me the question. If 1 comma, what is g? Centroid is what? 1 comma?
1 comma 4.
1 comma 4. And vertices a is what?
4 comma minus 8.
And what is b?
B is 1 comma 4. Oh.
Then what is the area of the triangle?
Sir. Connection, sir. The centroid of two vertices of a triangle is 4 comma minus 8 anundi sir. Adi centroid sir, 4 comma minus 8.
This is centroid, okay.
And vertices are minus 9 comma 7 and 1 comma 4.
Minus 9 comma 7, huh?
Yes sir.
This is A, minus 9 comma 7 and B is 1 comma 4.
1 comma 4, yes sir.
Okay. A, B, C, G. G is given, A is given, B is given, C is... We don't know C.
Yes, sir.
Amen. We have C is equal to, I told you, 3x minus x1 minus x2, comma, 3y minus y1 minus y2, I told you, na?
Yes, sir.
To get C.
Yes,
and
sir.
Chesham kuda ilanti solution. 3x అంటే సెంట్రాయిడ్ లో ఉన్నది x, y తీసుకోవాలి అండ్ ఇది x1, y1 అవుతుంది ఇది x2, y2 అవుతుంది
ఇప్పుడు నేను ఇలా కనుక్కున్నా సార్
ఎలా
ఎలా అంటే సెంట్రాయిడ్ ఫార్ములా x1 x2 x3 by 3 c ని x, y అనుకుని
అలా చేస్తే వచ్చేది ఇదే
ఓకే
ఈ 3 అదే కదా డినామినేటర్ లో ఉండే 3 ఇది
ఓకే
నువ్వు ఈక్వేట్ చేసావు కదా రెండు
అవును సార్
ఈక్వేట్ చేసి వచ్చేది ఇదే కదా మరి అప్పుడు సెంట్రాయిడ్ వచ్చిందా సి వచ్చిందా
సి ఇస్ 8 కామా 13 అని వచ్చింది సార్
ఓకే వి విల్ సి 3 ఇంటూ ఎక్స్ 3 4 జ 12 మైనస్ ఎక్స్ 1 మైనస్ 9 మైనస్ ఎక్స్ 2 మైనస్ 1 కామా 3 వై 3 8 జ మైనస్ 24 మైనస్ వై 1 మైనస్ 4 మైనస్ వై 2 ప్లస్ 4 క్యాన్సిల్ And 12 minus 9 minus 1, 10. 12 minus 10 under 2. 2 comma minus 24 is vertex C. Now you can find area easily. Area A is equal to of mod x1, y1, 1, x2, y2, 1, x3, y3, 1. Lay down the formula. Kuda on the area you just na answer kuda was today. So formula you just kuna nini. That you just say 9, 4, 1. And what is B? 1, 4, 1, what is C? 2 minus 24, 1 is equal to 1 by 2 mod of, directly I am doing determinant, that is 9 into 4, 1 ja 4 plus 24 and minus second one 4 and this is 1 minus 2 and plus third one 1 and this is minus 24 minus 8 minus 24 minus 8 is equal to 1 by 2. Simplification. Simplification is the answer.
Okay,
sir,
try this.
Okay.
Model so try this, sir. Formula kanna ne. Model ne kundam easy. Ippod mir mod sum okay. Jesar kada.
Alani chesar kani raha. X1, y2 minus y3. X2, y3 minus y1. X3, y1 minus y2. Formula verthi is the answer.
Yeah, okay, sir.
So, vachche value ne answer. Okay, na?
Okay, sir.
This is na?
Yes, sir.
Ortho center completed yesterday.
Yes, sir.
Circumcenter is there and in center is there.
In center is there.
And
yes,
more
sir.
Quadrilateral. Quadrilaterals also is there. We will complete today.
Okay,
and
sir.
Complete them.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Circumcenter. And you know already circumcenter definition. Circumcenter is nothing but what? The point of concurrency of perpendicular bisectors. We should take the midpoint and draw a perpendicular line. This is a perpendicular line. We should take a midpoint and we should draw a perpendicular line. We should take a midpoint. We should draw a perpendicular line. then the point of concurrency of these perpendicular bisectors of a triangle is called circumcenter, denotes by S. And from circumcenter to any vertices A, B, C, distances are equal. That's why we use in solution SA equal to SB equal to SC. Understand? So,
yes, sir.
If S is circumcenter, then SA equal to SB equal to SC is the condition. Why? Because from circumcenter to any vertex on the triangle, of the triangle, the length is same. Why? Because the triangle which is inside the circle, like this. So from center, this is the center of the circle. From center to any point on the circle, distances are same. That is nothing but radius. That is called circumradius. Okay. So this is the condition for circumcenter, and this is the first one. Second one, for a right angle triangle. For a right angle triangle, and very easy. For a right angle triangle ABC, where B is the orthocenter, already we discussed yesterday. B is the orthocenter at right angle, and the circumcenter is nothing but what, you know, the midpoint of the vertices of hypotenuse. The midpoint of vertices of hypotenuse is nothing but circumcenter. Why? Because if you draw the circle, you will get like this circle, and this is nothing but radius, sorry, diameter. And we know what. The midpoint of this only circumcenter, and this only center of the circle, that is only circumcenter. For right angle triangle, for right angle triangle, this only midpoint of hypotenuse, midpoint of hypotenuse is circumcenter. That is the second point. Now third one, if A x1 y1, B x2 y2, and O is 0, 0, or the vertices of a triangle, one vertex is 0, 0 here, then see, one vertex is 0, 0, then I gave you orthocenter also, k into x1 minus x2, okay, and where k also I gave you. For circumcenter also, we have formula. If one vertex is 0, 0, then circumcenter S is equal to, we have a little bit different, you should remember this, is you have y2 into x1 square plus y1 square minus y1 into x2 square plus y2 square by 2 into x1 y2 minus x2 y1. Comma, write in terms of x. x2 into same x1 square y1 square. x1 square plus y1 square. Minus your y1, then you will get x1. x1 into x2 square plus y2 square. By same part, you will get 2 into x1 y2 minus x2 y1 is the formula to find circumcenter if given one vertex is 0, 0. This is the formula. Okay. So
okay, sir.
Try to remember. Otherwise, you go on the condition SA equal to SB equal to SA. It will take less time. It will take little bit more time to solve. Okay, to get solution.
Okay, sir. And, yes, sir.
And one more for acute angle triangle, same like that only. For acute angle triangle. For acute angle triangle. What we discussed in yesterday for orthocenter, same for this also. S is inside. S is inside the triangle. For obtuse angle triangle, for obtuse angle triangle, S is outside. S is outside the triangle. For acute inside, for obtuse outside. Circumcenter and orthocenter both are same. Okay. Next, for a right angle triangle, already we discussed, that is the midpoint of the hypotenuse is nothing but circumcenter, and the relation between circumcenter, orthocenter and centroid. And this is very useful for problems.
Sir, blurring di koncham.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Better.
Sixth one. G, centroid. O, orthocenter. S, R, centroid, orthocenter, and circumcenter. Then G divides, means in centroid divides circumcenter and orthocenter. Centroid divides orthocenter and circumcenter. Centroid divides orthocenter and circumcenter. Yeah, orthocenter and circumcenter in the ratio 2:1. G divides orthocenter and circumcenter in the ratio 2:1. Therefore, bisection formula, that means you will get like this. This is orthocenter, this is circumcenter, this is centroid. And this is dividing orthocenter and circumcenter in the ratio 2:1. So we can use where m is 2, n is 1. So by using section formula, internal section formula, G is equal to 2 into circumcenter plus 1 into orthocenter by 2 plus 1, 3. M plus N, 3. This is one condition to find centroid. From this we can find what is orthocenter also. O is equal to 3 into G. 3G minus 2S. This is also one condition to find orthocenter, to find centroid. And to find circumcenter also we can write. That is what? S is equal to, see, 3G minus O by 2. This is the formula to find circumcenter. These three are the relations between circumcenter, orthocenter and centroid. Okay.
Okay.
If given circumcenter, orthocenter, we can find centroid. If given centroid, circumcenter, we can find orthocenter. If given orthocenter, centroid, we can find circumcenter. So, this is about circumcenter. And I will complete first in center and quadrilateral, then we will go to problems, okay?
Yeah, okay, sir.
Can I erase this?
Yes, sir.
Sound the geek. Incenter. Do you know the definition of incenter?
No, sir.
Incenter. You should remember, this is the last chance for you, okay?
Yeah, okay, sir.
You have no time to repeat, okay? So, incenter is nothing but in a triangle ABC, angle A, angle B, angle C, a line which is bisecting the angle A, means A by 2, you will get. Which is bisecting angle B, B by 2. Which is bisecting angle C, C by 2. This is incenter. This is angle bisector. The point of concurrency of internal angles, these are. The point of concurrency of internal angular bisectors is called incenter, denoted by I. We have external angular bisectors point of concurrency, excenters. More three excenters we have. So we need here this one, incenter. Incenter is nothing but the point of concurrency of internal angular bisectors. These are angular bisectors which are internal inside the triangle. So, the point of concurrency of internal angular bisectors is called incenter, denotes by I. Okay? And
okay, sir.
That this is D, this is E, this is F. And we know AC is small b, AB is small c, BC is small a, where ABC, small letters are the lengths AB, BC, AC. Okay, now this D or AD, AD is angular bisector. This AD divides BC, this is dividing BC. This AD divides BC in the ratio small c is to small b. Small c is to small b. This length and this length. Okay. This AD divides BC in the ratio this length and this length. And this BE, angular bisector, divides AC in the ratio this length here you will get, this length here you will get. That is what? AC. And this also divides this side in the ratio this length is to this length. So we can find this D. How we can find this D is dividing BC in the ratio. B we have, C we have no D, but we can find D. How we can find? By finding the length of these two, we can write ratios. I mean, ratio, right? M is to N. Then by using internal formula, section formula, we can find D easily. MX2 plus NX1 by M plus N formula. So this is one more point and one more. In center divides the internal angular bisector. In center divides the internal angular bisectors. Here we are discussing about AD angular bisector. I'm writing here. First one definition, no need to write, denotes with I. And AD internal angular bisector divides BC in the ratio, that is BD is to DC is equal to C is to B. BD is to DC is equal to C is to B. Second point, in center I divides angular bisector AD or BE or CF, whatever it is. I am taking one angular bisector AD. I divides means in center divides AD, I mean internal angular bisector, in the ratio, I'm writing C, this is we are discussing about AD, na? And remaining two we have to write, that is B plus C is to, and that A also we have to write. So this is the formula. For AD, this is the formula. For BE, you will get what? A plus C is to B. For CF, you will get what? B plus A is to C. So that is the ratio. Depending on question, we can use one of these three. So this is also one more very important point, that is the ratio or the finding point. And next, in center formula, I is equal to AX1 plus BX2 plus CX3 by A plus B plus C comma AY1 plus BY2 plus CY3 by A plus B plus C is the formula where small a, small b, small c are the lengths. I gave you already. A, B, C are the lengths. And X1, Y1, X2, Y2, X3, Y3 are the vertices. Those also will be given. By vertices, we can find the lengths, and substituting in the formula, you will get in center of any triangle. Okay, so this is about in center. And one more, in an equilateral triangle, this is also very important for problems. In an equilateral triangle, orthocenter is equal to circumcenter is equal to centroid is equal to in center. All are coincide. All are coincide. For only, in only equilateral triangle. If given vertices for an equilateral triangle and if they ask to find in center, it is enough to find centroid. Why? Because that is easy. And the centroid is nothing but orthocenter, circumcenter and in center. Okay. This is for only equilateral triangle. If any question asked, if given vertices for a triangle and asked to find in center, circumcenter, orthocenter, these three only different, difficult to find. Centroid is very easy. If asked to find in center, centroid, not centroid, orthocenter, circumcenter, first we have to check that is equilateral triangle or not. After finding, if we find that is equilateral triangle, it is enough to find centroid instead of circumcenter, orthocenter, in center. Okay. So this is okay, about sir. This. Okay. Now.
Okay.
Nature of quadrilaterals. Nature of quadrilateral. This is the last topic in 2D. Nature of quadrilateral. I think you know. Parallelogram, rhombus, yeah. Square, rectangle. Okay.
Okay.
Nature of quadrilaterals. Nature of quadrilaterals. Okay. The first point is, in quadrilateral ABCD, if that quadrilateral is NABCD quadrilateral, if that
sir,
quadrilateral
is
convincingly.
లేదు కనపడట్లేదు సార్ ఓకే సార్
ఓకే
ఎస్ సార్
ఇఫ్ దట్ క్వాడ్రిలేటరల్ ఈస్ పారలలోగ్రామ్ దెన్ ద ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్స్ ఆర్ సేమ్ ఏ బి సి డి దిస్ ఇస్ ద క్వాడ్రిలేటరల్ ఓకే So AB okay. parallel CD and BC parallel AD, okay? And AB okay, equal to CD, BC equal to AD also we can write if that is parallelogram, okay? And the diagonals are not same. AC not equal to BD for parallelogram. Second one. And the second one is rectangle. Rectangle for rectangle same side parallel sides are same AB parallel are equal to CD and BC equal to AD and also diagonals also same I think right diagonals yes, also sir. Same AC equal to BD but all adjacent sides having perpendicular 90 degrees okay that is rectangle And third one, square. For square, all sides are equal. AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to AD, and also AC equal to BD. Diagonals also same. And fourth one, rhombus. For rhombus, all sides are same. AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to AD, but AC not equal to BD. Diagonals are not same in rhombus. Okay. You know, five together rhombus and it.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Next, in parallelogram, and this is important, in parallelogram and rectangle and rhombus and square. For all four, in parallelogram, rectangle, rhombus, square, the diagonals bisect each other. The diagonals bisect each other. Bisect means passing through midpoint, okay? So in four quadrilaterals, the diagonals bisect each other. That is very important. I'm not writing here. It is enough to remember, or you can write. In above four, the diagonals are bisect each other the diagonals are bisect each other okay in four above four that is one more point next in rhombus a square the diagonals are perpendicular that we know already in rhombus r square in square the diagonals are clearly perpendicular in rhombus also the diagonals are clearly perpendicular in rhombus and square the diagonals are perpendicular that is one more point and next if a b c are the three vertices of a parallelogram which are consecutive a b c if a b c given to find d we have one formula in ib also we have this formula can I erase the first and second first second third
yes sir
If given ABC to find that fourth vertex where ABC are the consecutive vertices of a parallelogram, A, B, C, D. This D is not given. And X1, Y1, X2, Y2, X3, Y3, X4, Y4. This X4, Y4 is not given. Then that D is equal to the not given vertex is equal to when A, B, C, D are in consecutive vertices of a parallelogram. D is equal to this is 1, this is 3, this is 2, this is 4. We are finding 4, 1. Na? So 1 plus 3 minus 2. That is X1 plus X3 minus X2, comma Y1 plus Y3 minus Y2. This is the formula. Okay. Adding these two.
X1 plus X3, yes, sir.
X3. 1 plus 3 minus 2. Why? Because we are finding 4. Okay. This is X4, Y4. Okay, na? So this is also one formula. Very important formula. Next, if X1, Y1 and X2, Y2 are the opposite vertices of a square, then the other two vertices of, this is also important. If X1, Y1 and X2, Y2 are the opposite vertices, means like this, AC or BD. Or opposite vertices of a square, vertices of a square, then remaining two. Then remaining two are, that is the formula, and this is similar in previous formula, X1 plus X2 plus R minus Y1 minus Y2, I think. Yeah. Y1 minus Y2 by 2, comma Y1 plus Y2 plus R minus X1 minus X2 by 2. These are the remaining two vertices. Okay. This is also very important. This is also very important. Understand?
Yes, given two X1 vertices, plus
for a square, if given A, B, C, D square, if given AC to find BD, if given BD to find AC, opposite vertex if given, to find remaining opposite, two opposite vertices, these are the formula. After getting four vertices, we can find, we can do anything. Okay. And next, area of quadrilateral. Can I erase this?
1 minute.
Questions we will discuss later, okay?
Yeah, okay, sir.
Are you copying?
Yeah. Yes, sir. Koncham blur gundi, sir. Na net
malankunta.
Yeah. Indak nunchi undi, sir. Blur ga undi.
Asal kanipinchatle.
Koncham, koncham.
చూడు చూసి చెప్పు హలో ఎవ్రీథింగ్ లిజన్
మీరు రాసినప్పుడు ఉంటది సార్ అది
అదే ఏరియా ఆఫ్ క్వాడ్రిలేటరల్ క్వాడ్రిలేటరల్ బాగా వస్తున్నారా ఏరియా ఆఫ్ క్వాడ్రిలేటరల్ అండ్ వెరీ ఈజీ ఇఫ్ ఏబిసిడి ఆర్ ద వర్టిసెస్ ఆఫ్ A quadrilateral X1, Y1, X2, Y2, X3, Y3, X4, Y4, then the area A is equal to, then the area A is equal to half mod delta of X1 minus X2, X1 minus X3, and Y1 minus Y3, and X2 minus X4, and Y2 minus Y4. So this is the formula to find area of the quadrilateral, and we have one more also. R area A is equal to half mod X1, X2, X3, X4, X1. Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, Y1. This is also one formula to find area of the quadrilateral. See, for triangle we use X1, X2, X3, again X1. Y1, Y2, Y3, Y1. Like that we use for triangle. For quadrilateral, X4, X1. For five vertices of polygon, X5, again X1. Next six vertices, X6, X1. Like that. For n vertices of polygon, we can write what? for n vertices polygon we can write a is equal to half mod x1 x2 x3 so on xn x1 again y1 y2 y3 so on yn y1 we can use this formula for n vertices polygon okay now
okay sir
can I erase this
yes sir
now area is this one and also we can find in one more way for a parallelogram this is the height and this is also one more height let p1 and p2 are the heights and this is the angle between adjacent sides of a parallelogram then the area a is equal to p1 p2 by sin theta then the area is what p1 p2 by sin theta where p1 is the length distance between the parallel sides of a parallelogram this is one distance this is one distance p1 p2 and this is the angle which is between adjacent sides of a parallelogram then the area is p1 p2 by sin theta next one more if p is the length of the diagonal of a square p is length of the diagonal of a square so this is p and this is p both are same in square if p is the length of the diagonal of a square then first one then the length of side length is the length of side is p by root 2 right the length of side is p by root 2 if given diagonal length we can find side if given side we can find diagonal length by using this formula okay if x is the side then x is equal to p by root 2 here if given p we can find x if given x we can find p and one more area of the square if given the diagonal length p then the area of the square a is equal to p square by 2 p square by 2 if given diagonal also first find p then substitute in the formula area you will get area of the square so this is about quadrilateral so this is the concept for 2d understand more extensions yes, are there first you should learn perfectly these then we go to questions so can I give you questions
yes sir
and I will give you very easy questions today
okay sir
only one thing you have to read this concept perfectly then only you can solve the problems so yeah, alante questions ay standard direct ga unna concept meeda question ay ante ga
okay
concept ku related ga unna question ay istha okay
okay sir
సరే నేను ఇంకో లింక్ పంపించానా
yes sir
క్వశ్చన్స్ కి
యా ఓకే సార్
ఓకే పంపిస్తా చూడు